Hi guys, it's Maaike. I'm back with Creator Smile Advent Calendar number 17. I called it Retro Tech, but the set is actually called On the Phone, which was too obvious. And you might have seen the thumbnail. I was trying to go for something a bit retro, like 70s acid color tights. Don't know if you ever seen them, but those. Also big in the 80s and the 60s or 50s maybe, I don't know. Lycra leggings, I remember those well. Anyway, I already stamped them and cut them out. For the background, I'm using the basic ovals and distress inks. And I wanted to go for orange and pink first, then I added some yellow too. Mustard seed, picked raspberry, and carved pumpkin. That's usually my favorite color when it comes to ink blending or combination. But yeah, we'll see. Because here's a disruptor of worlds. Cheered. There he is. Yeah, he has to be in on the act lately. Don't know why. His sister, Chalk, is the destroyer of laundry, the laundrinator. Anyway, he settled down on the windowsill there. There was a box I was given earlier this week, and he doesn't fit into it, but it doesn't stop him. So you see, I like it as it is now, but then I thought I'll even it out with a bit of yellow and go over it and mix it all together, and now my picked raspberry is reddish instead of pink. So, not my favorite. So I dropped the stencil there before I cleaned it, and you will see that later. There are smudges. So I thought I would do it. Or maybe my hands are dirty. I don't know sure what happened, but there were pink smudges later. I can't really see it when I do the voiceover, can I? There they are. So I thought I'll redo it. And I thought I'd do it off camera, but I'll show you that instead I went for mustard seed and picked raspberry alone. And together that already makes an orangey color, so I didn't really need the carved pumpkin. And here's my little acid print. I think it's called acid print, I'm not actually sure, but it is really vibrant, almost tie-dye looking. Yes, and that was the third time, because on the other side I also smudged it because the masking peeled off. So this was lucky enough to do it on the panel, so I could just turn it around and then just attach it to the card base I made earlier, and no one will ever know. There you go. And the hello, I'm just going to leave it as is. I'm mounting it with double thickness of foam, so it's more raised than the other image. It's my phone. Now, in the 80s, I had a minty colored phone. I also had a hamburger one, or Subway sandwich kind of one. I always fancied that one, and I couldn't find it. I got the hamburger. This is what I wanted. But minty wasn't my favorite color, because of work uniform. I had to wear a mint coverall, I think it is, like a jacket, all week. And that was horrible mint, so I know. But the gray green I like, and this the silvery green, I like that too. But so I went for pink. I wanted to do it minty first, but then I thought that maybe the background doesn't really go together. So the little inside there in my work past, and that was it. In the 80s actually, And if you're from the Netherlands, you know the HEMA. Now they have polos and normal trousers, but these were like overalls you had to wear. Like grandma, but anyway, mint, not my color. I'm glad they don't have those anymore. But at least it would protect your clothes, so that was good, you know. And just some pinks. And I tried to match the color next to the phone with the background, but I thought it was a bit dark, so I go over it with another lighter orange, also from the Crafit markers, hoping it would bleach out the color that's there already because it has more alcohol in it. But I went over it with the blender as well, just to make sure. See, it's way too dark. So I use this just to fill in the gap so it looks like it's properly cut out. And I thought it's still too dark, so a bit of a blender. I think it matches better now. And of course you don't have to do this, but I like it as a trick. And that's the mint. Nope. Some foam tape as well. And that's pretty much the card finished. So as always, the links to the Facebook group and the Create a Smile webshop are down below. And I hope to see you again tomorrow. Until then, bye.